I'm Mary Parker, and welcome to A Dose of Science. As we get ready for this year's AACR meeting, virtually of course, we would like to highlight three research projects utilizing 3D in vitro models. All three of these projects are intended to improve preclinical oncology platforms, and the scientists involved will present their work at AACR. First up, KOLIN joins us from Cypre Biotech. His project involves a hydrogel-based assay for drug screening that uses patient-derived xenograft cell lines, or PDX cell lines, in combination with other cell types. By using more than one cell type, KOLIN and his team are able to better mimic the tumor microenvironment. After all, real patients contain all kinds of cells. Welcome, KOLIN.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks for being here. So what is the advantage of hydrogel versus other matrices for this assay?
Hydrogels offer the ability to define the matrix properties a bit more, so we can bioengineer the starting material for our needs more so than the conventional matrices. So things like the physiological properties, immune infiltration, tumor growth and invasion, and modulation of the stiffness, which are high on the list for developing next generation technologies.
So it's basically you can just control it more and make sure the parameters are set in stone.
Exactly.
Cool. So which cell types can be combined in this assay, and which types do you have to plan to include next?
So currently, we utilize the patient-derived xenograft cells, the PDX tumor cells, as well as fibroblast and immune cells from PBMCs. But we're also interested in using tumor-infiltrating lymphocytes derived from the tumor ex vivo tissue, as well as more heterogeneous mixtures of cell types. We hope to expand to other cell types like macrophages or other immunosuppressive cells, as well as looking at different client-specific cell therapies like CAR-T. And we're also considering other disease models in the future that are non-oncology based.
Okay. So how do you plan to expand the current tumor model panel?
Sure. So to date, we have validated against lung tumor models, colorectal cancer, as well as renal cell carcinoma. But we aim to build out additional solid tumor indications, such as breast cancer, brain cancers, melanoma, pancreatic, gastric, et cetera.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much for joining me.
Happy to be here.
Next up, Julia Schuler, research director for Charles River Freiburg. She will tell us about using 3D spheroid cultures for colorectal cancer. The model is intended to mimic tumor secretions in an environment similar to what is seen in patients. The goal is to model the differences between metastatic cancer cell environments and non-metastatic cancer cell environments. The difference is important since effective drugs would target the metastatic cells. Welcome, Julia.
Welcome, and thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here. So what are the main differences between the three setups you tested?
So we tested three setups. The first one was the classical 2D setting. Then we went into a 3D spheroid culture in ultra-low attachment plates. And in a third round, we tested the 20 lines in a 3D setting co-cultured with fibroblasts.
Did the analysis of the secreted proteins reveal unexpected findings?
Yes, indeed it did. The expected finding was that the metastatic and the non-metastatic cell lines had different cytokines patterns. The unexpected part was that the PDX-derived cell lines, so our own cell lines, clustered all in the non-metastatic cluster, although they came from metastatic patients.
Okay. Can you explain a little bit more what the importance of that difference is in terms of how the drug works?
So it might be that the PDX-derived cell lines are heterogeneous, so they do not necessarily show themselves as metastatic only by the cytokine profile, but we might have to look more into detail what drives them into a metastatic setting or not.
Okay, that makes sense. What are the next steps?
The next steps will be that we go into an in vivo setting. So we will use a few of those lines and implant them orthotopically into mice and see then if the cytokine profile also is resembling our in vitro setting or is completely different.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Finally, we have Anna ERKSTAM from BioRepairia in Sweden. Her research also involves focusing on metastatic breast cancer cells, this time through patient-derived xenografts in zebrafish, Ultimately, this technique could be used for both preclinical drug screening and potentially for individualized medicine. Welcome, Anna.
Thank you so much.
So what are the advantages of the zebrafish larva system?
There are a lot of advantages with using the system. It's a great system to be used as a complement to mouse PDX models. But as a system by itself, it's really cool since we're using zebrafish larvae very early in the process. So these embryos or larvae are actually transparent. And when we inject human cancer cells into these systems, we dye the cells with a red fluorescent dye, and we can actually live track the development of the tumors and metastasis within the living embryo throughout the treatment period, which is 3 days. So it's a very fast and agile system. The embryos do not have an own immune system when they are this young, meaning that we don't have to pre-treat them with anything, and the tumor cells will form a small solid microtumor really fast with neovascularization, allowing the metastatic cells to disseminate into the different parts of the larvae.
And they live on a little plate, right? So they can be fed really easily into the optical equipment?
Yeah, we're actually housing them in a 96-well plate in individual wells. So we follow each individual embryo throughout the whole treatment period. And we use approximately 20 individuals per group. But for 100 individuals, it's the same size as a 96-well plate.
Cool. So is this a particularly good model for breast cancer specifically, or could it work with other cancers as well?
Oh, it could be used for any cancers. We have done validation studies together with you at Charles River for lung cancer, but it works for all solid tumors, both PDX and CDX models, as well as hematopoietic tumors.
How likely do you think it is that this technology could lead to faster, cheaper, individualized medicine?
Oh, so that's the ultimate goal for us. We are doing several clinical collaborations where we look at treatment outcomes in patients. So we get biopsies from patients, inject them into our zebrafish systems, and could actually predict the treatment outcomes in these patients within 5 days. And our first product for this will be on the market within 2 years. So it's coming really fast.
That's amazing. We have seen from these three projects that 3D cancer modeling is undergoing a renaissance. Technologies that were developed a few years ago are now advanced enough to be used for larger preclinical projects and potentially for individualized patient screening. As optical and modeling technology improve, we inch closer to better, faster, and more predictive cancer models. Thank you.